All right. What am I going to make today? That depends. What do we have? Okay, so we have key doors, we have activator doors, we have paintings, we have nightstands, we have a few other things. You know what we don't have? We don't have a good furniture set. And what is the most important piece of furniture? The couch. You know what? Considering that this is supposed to be kind of like a fancy set of things, typically, why not go with the white, perfectly unstained, just basically begging to be stained by some red wine couch? You know, the thing that all fancy people have. Like it's a requirement for some reason. Not entirely sure how I want to go about this. Maybe. What if I did this instead? I feel like that is a. That's an alright couch. A sofa. Is it a sofa? Okay, so often convertible to a bed, but doesn't necessarily mean it has to be. And a couch, a piece of furniture with no arms used for lying. Okay, so it is a sofa. Really ought to change up how this one works because it's the desk and I think it actually doesn't spawn anything anymore. But I am going to make it spawn something. Okay, searchable. that is the collision size I'm looking for. I'm gonna just paste it down here. Now I gotta So I think I got the networking library to a point where I could use it, and that's actually my tests, but I need to test it out in GDevelop to make sure it works the way I want. I tested it out on a test program, but you know, I needed, what is it? Alright, it's objects. Mundane objects. I need to test it out in a GDevelop situation. Does this work? Stay hydrated. It's important. It keeps you alive. accidentally pulled a cable. All right, point is down here. Not exactly where I expected, but and it seems like the collision agrees with me. Okay. First, I'm going to take a look. I just got rid of that and went with that. A little too low. I think it's like plus 64 or something. And these seems to be minus 64. That's probably what I meant. Okay, it wasn't what I meant, but it's probably what I was thinking. Okay, so it wasn't what I was thinking, but it was probably what I was trying to remember off the top of my head. I can say at least that much. All right, this looks correct. I am going to have to do something about these broken equipment displays. There we go. Check mark. How much time did that take? Alright, that took some time, but it didn't take as much as I thought it would. I'm gonna put it right there. Wait, is that aligned correctly? It looks nice. Oh, at least I got the diamond. I'm gonna go in and see what the issue is, and I think I know what the issue is. It's because I was working on no network in one player. Actually, if I remember correctly, there's also another issue that I saw. Other than 3 and 4 not being able to. Any case. Also, let's see. Somewhere around here. Spawn players. Should actually fix that, but we still have an issue. What collision or what? What is the thing it is that I need to change? Okay, it's something with it's a frame zero sprite part with the animation 4 that I need to change to animation 0. That's correct. Right, on to this. Going to be completely honest, I have absolutely no idea how this is supposed to work. Okay, I get it. So, if I am understanding this correctly, all of the things within this, which doesn't have any of the equipment things, are being set to, like, the first player's position, and then moved over to the correct position. So it should still be messed up, but it should be a little less messed up now since I've added that. As in, it should actually display the equipment stuff for player 2, despite the fact that player 2 doesn't have equipment, neither does player 1, but currently the code doesn't check for that. Whereas the code when playing single player without a network does. I really should go ahead and change how that particularly works. It should be either, it should have an or condition where it's if you're playing, if the global player's variable is set to 1 or network is set to 1. It just wouldn't make sense with 0, and it wouldn't make sense with more than 4, since there's no case handling more than 4. Okay, let's see. Okay, it's still messed up. Why is this? Oh, but the cameras are functioning automatically now. I've noticed another issue, which was I was too distracted by this that I forgot about this. And I'm an idiot. So, several issues to solve. And quite some time that I wasn't solving issues. Sometimes life is like that, I suppose. I'm gonna disable this. Currently, there's no way for me to test this since there's no networking. But let's see. Actually, I would need to test whether or not. Actually, I can see the issue. Player 2, 3, and 4 adds a half screen to their position. So it would be available, we would be able to see it on frame 1. I can't remember if there's no fade. If there was a fade, then I think technically it would be at maximum opacity on frame 1, and thus you couldn't see it then. Any case. I forgot what it was called. Prefix, right. Actually, the reason why it's called prefix is because when I was using GDevelop's networking, I'd go ahead and prefix whatever connection data or sending player data over with a specific value. I think that's everything. So these badge things aren't here. Maybe that's to be expected, because maybe it's actually probably wouldn't show up. Ah, but the charge does. Now the information board, the I board, isn't displaying properly, and also this isn't fixed, but we'll get there. First, I want to make sure that these two aren't just linked together. That's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. Why does that have to be that way? What was it to, that's what it was. Okay, I also see some error with the ability, because I'm pretty sure he's supposed to go fast in his own sludge. Patch of hitbox is not global. Okay, yeah, that's probably something I should not have done. Okay, there's still the issue from before. Wait, hold on, why are they? It shouldn't be like this. And I didn't even fix the issue. Why is it like this? It changed one line of code. Is it controller on the player then? How did it work with one player one time? Granted, it didn't work the way I intended, but it did do something that I somewhat intended. Why did it work then? Or why did it do the half working then? Alright. I suppose that's programming for you. Sometimes some things work and you have absolutely no idea why. Or is that just me? Finished my Rubik's Cube. I'm just waiting on a compile. All right, at least something is working. Maybe. Hey, what do you know? Just to make sure it's not broken the other way around. Nope, other people go slow through this. All right, at least that works. This I'm not entirely sure about. Yep, and it's running away from the screen. All right. All right, let's see. I get why this doesn't work, and it's because I forgot to copy this over here. That is yet another mistake that I continue to make. All right. Now that's out of the way, hopefully. It's almost time, and I forgot to make a painting. Not entirely sure if I'll be able to do it. After all, there's only so many paintings that I can make. They are stationary, which is good. Now I know they're not running away and are, in fact, still within the region of the screen, even if they're not visible. I get it. I get the timer's on. I'm going to continue until I have implemented this. I wonder if I should do a shimmering effect with this. Like, yeah, the moonlight is shimmering into the. If one could tell what that was, the murderer. But I wonder if I should make it, like, move. May or may not be streaming at like 1, like 12:30, 1:30. If I am, I'll see you then. If I am not, I'll see you like at 10:30. At 10:30 p.m. already see that it is implemented. Very well. All right. That is going to do it for me today. So if you were in chat or otherwise just watching, thank you. If you're watching this later on YouTube, thank you. Until I see you again, this is goodbye.